Just last month, I thought of buying something for myself. And guess what? I ordered from Shopee an Amlogic Android box which bears the name X96 Air. This has cost me 1,049 Philippine pesos or around $21. I have done a lot of research about Amlogic Android boxes in the past that they can be easily converted into a mini personal computer or a retro gaming machine. And the X96 Air perfectly fits my budget. Although the product description states that it has 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage, I know that this might not be the real specs of this Android box, since Amlogic Android boxes are quite expensive when it comes to their price. Well, just take a look at Mi Box S, Mi Cool KM2, or Stronglip S1. They are perhaps the most popular Amlogic Android boxes here in the Philippines today. These devices have 2GB of RAM and they are sold for around 2,000 to 3,500 Philippine pesos or around $40 to $70. But anyway, I took the risk and ordered the X96 Air. So, what was the real specs of the X96 Air that I have just received? Did I get scammed? Or did I regret ordering this in the first place? Or was it still a good buy? Let's all find out. Okay, let's find out if my intuition is correct by doing a teardown of this Android box and finally reveal its real specs. In the box, it says it has an Amlogic S905X3 processor, and for me, that is the most important thing about this box. If it has less RAM or storage as it was specified in the product description, well, I don't really mind. I can deal with that for as long as it has an Amlogic processor. Let's now open the box and let's see what's included. We got the Android box itself in here. And then we have the power adapter. The supplied remote control. Here is the user manual. And lastly, we have the HDMI cable. For everybody's information, the remote control is not yet supplied with AA batteries, so you have to provide your own. The supplied power adapter has a rated voltage of 5 volts and a maximum current output of 2 amperes, which is really quite good. Let's now take a closer look of the Android box itself. On the top side, it has the X96 Air logo. On the front side, this is where the digital clock LCD screen is located. This will light up when the Android box is turned on. This is also the location of the infrared receiver of the remote control. On the left side, you will see in here a single 2.0 USB port, a micro SD card slot, and a single 3.0 USB port. That's all for this side. At the back portion of the Android box, we have the power port, an optical audio port, an HDMI port, an Ethernet port, an audio video or AV port, and lastly a USB 2.0 port. On the right side, well, there's nothing to see in here. Checking the underside, this is where you will find the Android box specs. It says in here that it has 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. We will see later on if what they have written here is correct. You will notice that there's a sticker here that if ever it got damaged, the warranty will become void. I plan of opening this box to show you what is inside this little box, so I don't really mind if I void the warranty. So, it's now time to pry open this box. I'll fast forward this video to save us some time. At sa wakas, I got it open. As you can see on its top cover, it has a bigger heatsink compared to other Android boxes that I own. I am happy to see that they put a bigger heatsink to prevent the box from overheating. Connected ang heatsink sa mismong processor with a thermal pad. Let's now remove the thermal pad to find out kung totoo nga talagang AMLogic S905X3 ang processor ng X96 Air. This is the moment of truth we are all waiting for. And yes, there it is! I am glad to report that the processor is indeed an AMLogic S905X3. I can now finally sleep without any worries tonight thinking that the processor could have been faked out in the product description. You can also see in here that the board version is BM805H_141V2.2-19473. This is very important to take note as this is very helpful in looking for a stock or any compatible firmware for this Android box. Let's take a look at the front side again. This is the LCD screen which displays the time and other useful info when the Android box is turned on. And beside that LCD screen is the infrared receiver that receives the signal from the remote control. Going back to the board, these multiple chips in here that has the exact same size are called the RAM chips. We have 4 of them on this side of the board and I believe there are another set of 4 RAM chips on the underside. Well, let's check them out later. Let's try to flip this board up and see what's on the other side. There are 2 screws that we need to remove in order for us to be able to do that. So let's do that. Checking the other side of the board, we can find in here the Wi-Fi antenna which seems to be soldered to the board. In my opinion, with some modification, it's possible to solder an external Wi-Fi antenna to improve the Wi-Fi signal reception of this Android box. This is the Wi-Fi chip of the board, and the model is Realtek 8189FTV. It's also important to take note of this, as this will help us to find a compatible ROM for this box. And this chip over here is the NAND flash, or the storage drive. And this sticker here is the MAC address of this device. And lastly, as I have mentioned earlier, we have another set of 4 RAM chips on this side of the board. I believe these chips are 256 MB each, making all chips combined together to get 2 GB of RAM. Well, let's verify that later on. Now, let's close down this box and take a quick tour of its original operating system. Upon booting the X96 Air, the LCD screen will light up, showing you the default time. But once you have connected to the internet, that will be automatically updated. The boot up screen looks like this. It's an X96 Air logo followed by some animation. The home screen is not the typical arrangement you usually see on other Android boxes. This one has a very different user interface, but it's still easy to navigate. You will see in here the shortcut icons for most common pre-installed apps that includes YouTube, Netflix, Kodi, and most importantly, the Google Play Store. You can modify the list of apps to be shown in here according to your preference. In the apps menu, it just basically lists down all pre-installed apps in this Android box. You will notice in here that I have already installed IDA64 and Device Info HW. They are not included in the pre-installed apps. I installed them manually for the sake of checking the real specs of this Android box and validate my intuition that this box only has 2 GB of RAM and 16 GB of storage. Let's do the checking by opening the Device Info HW. Under the SoC tab, it reports that it has an AMLogic processor, which is basically correct. However, as you take a look at the RAM and flash size, it's pretty evident that this box only has 2 GB of RAM and 16 GB of storage. And what they have written on the box is completely fake. I am right after all. But please, you have to take note that for the price of 1,049 Philippine pesos, I am still pretty happy since you would rarely get this kind of specs at this price point. The AMLogic processor is what makes all the difference. These kind of specs are already similar to Mi Box S, Mi Cool KM2 and Strong Deep S1. Next, we go to the Movie tab. It does not have any apps yet, but you can add your favorite movie app by clicking the Add icon. Under the Music tab, it only has the default music player, and you can replace this with the app of your choice. Lastly, the Settings tab, we have two choices. One is the basic version and the other one is the advanced version. If you want to tweak the settings of this box, this is where you do it. Now, let me explain why I chose an Android box with an ARM Logic processor. First and foremost, ARM Logic processors are faster and more reliable as compared to other processors of the same league. Many of the Android boxes now available in the market mostly contains Rockchip processors, which are very prone to overheating, which slows down the performance of the Android device due to thermal throttling. Second, you can install two variants of Android OS in this box. You can install the Android TV version if you want to control your box just like a smart TV. And you also have the option to install the pure Android version if you want more flexibility and functions typical to an Android phone or tablet. The choice is definitely yours. Third, you can convert this into a mini computer by installing a compatible Linux OS such as Manjaro and Armian. As you can see in here, I have installed Manjaro OS into an SD card and run it on this Android box. If you are just doing basic stuff such as internet browsing, document typing, or simply coding, well, this can serve as a low-cost alternative for a personal computer. How wonderful is that? And lastly, my favorite of them all is that you can convert this box into a retro gaming machine by installing MULEC. I was born in the mid-80s and I spent my childhood in the 90s. This was the time wherein game consoles such as Nintendo, Sega, and PlayStation were common household names. I can still vividly remember playing Super Mario, Sonic, Mortal Kombat, and many other games with my friends. For me, that was the best era growing up as a kid. Installing MULEC and being able to play all these popular games bring back all those memorable experiences that I had during my yesteryears. And that never fails to put a smile on my face. And now I enjoy playing these games with my daughter who is 7 years old now. And she loves playing them. And nothing beats that father and daughter bonding time. On my future videos, I will teach you how to install all these compatible third-party operating systems in your X96R or any other ARM Logic Android box with the same specs, and experience the same excitement that I had. Stay tuned to the channel for more helpful videos. Alright, that's it for now. Hanggang sa muli mga ka-frugal. This is Lawrence, and have a good day!